I've got a steel bar, a lot of lumber, a couple steel pins, duct tape, a little bit of rope, and a cinder block. Backyard material is what I could scrap together. Most people would call it a catapult, but the technical scientific term for it is a trebuchet. Basically, it's a long wooden pole that uses gravity to launch stuff.
Here we are.
That was a really high launch. Originally, I wanted to do a couple of experiments on the flight trajectory of different objects and how water affected those flights.
He came in fully loaded with calculations and drawings and some of his own prototypes.
We use what's called the makerspace. Basically, we just kind of get together and we try to solve problems by building stuff.
It's definitely going to be memorable, and it allows them to figure out what they like and what they don't like, what they're good at.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
That's where significant learning happens, when the students are drawn towards something.
There you go, play fetch.
And we're able to provide the resources and the space and the guidance to help them have their idea come to fruition.
It's gonna pull down. Science isn't just in a classroom. You can go out and you can see these forces in action. I don't have to be told that a lever is gonna exert forces differently based on distances from the fulcrum, and come out here and build a trebuchet. That was a good one.
Gets everybody in the club jazz to see a successful project and what persistence will do.
It really teaches you just how to take everything that you're doing and apply it, but come out understanding the concepts behind it is very important.